Join with me in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you, just praising you this morning. We do want to tell you how much we love you. You are such a blessing to us, God, to know who you are, but especially to be known by you, that you have brought us into your family through your Son, Jesus, by the power of the Spirit. And we pray that as we come before you right now, that we would continue worshiping you in spirit and truth, that as we worship in this time of giving of our offering, that it would be in glory to you, that you would help us to be obedient in what you've called us to give, and give sacrificially and cheerfully, Lord, to the things that you are doing. And we pray that it is all used for your glory. Thank you so much, God, for this new year as we start 2022, that we would spend time just devoted to you in prayer, in study of your word, in fellowshipping together, Lord, in breaking bread together. So use us today, Father, in your wonderful name, Jesus, we do pray. Amen. You may be seated. As we're passing those out, I have one quick staffing update. It is a good one. I want to say it like that. Let's start off with that, right? Sometimes the staffing updates have been somewhat sad or somber. This one's actually really good. We just want to update you. So the elders have been praying for God's guidance. Sam has been here just leading us through this time to really see where are we at? What do we need? Where is God taking us? So something we noticed was really just how many people in our church have gone through trials, trauma, loss. I mean, if you think about just the last year, 2 years, there's been a lot of that. There's such a need to be organized also in taking care of our congregation. So after a lot of prayer, meetings, prayer, meetings, discussions, and some research, we actually worked out a plan. So I'm going to have Ken Fairweather, if he would stand up, he's right over here. Carol, you can stand up if you'd like to as well. She's much part of this. So Ken Fairweather, who's the senior, he was our senior adults pastor over on board. He'll be transitioning into our new congregational care pastor. So what that means is his role, he's going to be able to see to the needs of our people who are sick, in hospital, have death in the family, who are shut in, just really making sure our congregation is taken care of well, because there are so many people that are in need, and we need somebody to organize that, and we really appreciate the time that we've spent with Ken and Carol on working through this, and what this looks like, and the transition. So we've met with them. They've had several meetings with the leadership to iron out all the details and to work with the leadership team of Encore to make sure this is a smooth transition as well. And so we just wanted to praise the Lord for that, for them. Thank you for taking on this new ministry role. If you have other questions, if you'd like to ask Ken, he will be available after the service to work on that. But with that, that's it.
Everybody, I tell you what, I want you to turn to people around you and just say, Happy New Year. Happy New Year. Some of you aren't so sure about that. We're going to go into it. I want to invite you to join us in 21 days of prayer. And I'd like to begin this morning with a prayer poll. Prayer survey. So I've got several questions I want to ask. How many of you have prayed a lot of prayers in your lifetime? Can I see your hands? Prayed a lot of prayers. Thank you. How many of you have a prayer request before God right now? Something you're praying about. Thank you. Something you want God to do, somewhere you want Him to move in your life. How many of you would say, sometimes prayer is difficult for me? Can I see your hands? You get up in the morning and there's no angel to fist bump you or pat you on the back and say, atta boy, and you begin trying to pray, and it's like everything in the universe is turned against you. Your phone starts dinging with messages you have to attend to right now. Or you glance at the ceiling fan and put a lot of dust on that fan. I've got to clean it right now. It's like how many of you have ever dealt with distractions when you've tried to pray? Now, see your hands. That's like the entire universe is. Like, I have a friend who says, when he tries to pray, his thoughts are like monkeys jumping around trees. It's a pre-em description of me so often. How many of you have prayed in the middle of a crisis? And that's typically when we pray, when things are desperate, And God invites us in His grace and His love and mercy to come to Him in a crisis. Years ago, after an automobile accident, my wife and I were both in the hospital, and the nurses were having a hard time getting IVs and checking into her arm, and they tried, and she was crying, and there were bruises, and it was just one of those really hard times. I happened to be in the same room, and I had just read Psalm 50:15, and in prayer, I claimed it at a time of crisis. Neither of us had slept for several days. I claimed Psalm 50:15. I want you to repeat it after me. The Lord says, call to me in the day of trouble.
Call to me in the day of trouble.
And I will deliver you.
And I will deliver you.
And you will glorify me.
And you will glorify me.
Psalm 50:15.
Call to me in the day of trouble.
Call to me in the day of trouble. And I will deliver you.
And I will deliver you.
And you will glorify me.
And you will glorify me.
And those promises are given to encourage us when it looks like the wheels are coming off, headed to a ditch, and our families, and our health, the people we care about, our finances at work. The Lord just invites us to come to Him in a crisis. So I've got one last question. And this is not. Thank you. hear these prayers. bless you as you leave.